in terms of developing infrastructure for them. Qonix is a partner. It's a government body which developed your electronic city. So a similar type of a much larger volume of electronic city is something which they have planned. So the entire plan is of acquiring 12,072 acres, which they are doing it in phase wise. As part of that, already 2,072 acres is already acquired by them. And another few phases, they'll be acquiring another 10,000 acres. So a mini, not a mini, a much larger electronic city is what you can expect in this particular ITIR, Information Technology Investment Region, which has been planned. It's actually coming up on the Jagdalpur-Chikbalapur road. I'll show you in a much better map further. Next slide, please, Amit. Yeah, thank you. So that is one region which I mentioned about, the ITIR. And the second region which I will be taking you through is the aerospace park, which is actually a total of 3,000 acres, phase by phase, which they are developing. So 1,000 acres has already been allocated, which you might be knowing, where as it talks about aerospace itself, aerospace SEZ. So you have major companies like Boeing, Airbus, Bombard. You have Mercedes, Chrysler, also Daimler, which is setting up a plant there. So there is, apart from that, there are a lot of IT companies who have also mentioned their interest into setting up parks over there in terms of their further expansions. Then you have the business park, which is actually coming on to the north part of the airport, which is a 300 acre development, which is more of a hardware park, which they have planned for. Then you have a financial city, which has also been planned towards North Bangalore. So these are the four major developments which have been planned, and it is already taken up in terms of developments towards North Bangalore. That's majorly the MLE area. The next slide, please. Amit, thank you. So this is what I was mentioning about. The marking which is showing one, which is the BIAL's IT investment region, which is a 12,000 acre entire land parcel. And the second one is the Aero SEZ, which is a 3,000 acre development where a lot of companies actually shell from Whitefield. Am I audible, guys? Yeah. If any issue in terms of my
yes.
voice? Yes, if you are audible.
Okay. So, the second part is the Aero SEZ, which is the 3,000 acres, which is coming up at the bottom part, which is marked as 2. And the third one is the Finance City, which is just next to it. And the fourth one is the, you have the Devanahalli Business Park, which is just above the airport. Why I have noted all these things is, if you look at our location, where the Project Godrej Reserve is coming up, which is marked in that star mark in red, it is in the middle of these four huge developments as such. You're more near to the BIAL IT, which is coming up, as well as you have easy connectivity towards the Devanahalli Business Park. So it is strategically located in between this huge chunk of hub, which is coming up. So when a customer is looking at in terms of investment, these are the things which you can easily portray and show it across so that they'll also understand, and it's more easier for you to pitch the area as a location for development and a good return. Just to give a rough example, I would wish to relate it. Electronic City, if you look at, was something which was developed as an area. Before that, you had your silk board and all those areas, which have developed in a much better way. So HSR layout, just to give an example, is much before your electronic city, but it is developed in a beautiful way. So these areas, which if you look at Godrej, where we are present, in and around there are a lot of planned development happening from different builders. So you can expect the area to come up in a beautiful and a planned way. Something similar to HSR is what you can always relate to. Yeah. Next slide, Amit. Amit, if you could run through the location video, maybe. Yeah, it's visible now. Thank you. Landmark where you can take a left. This is the junction where you have to take a left. Guys, you saw something where you had to take a U-turn and come back. So from the project to the main airport road, it's actually 3.5 kilometers. But due to this, if somebody is coming from the airport side towards the project, they'll have to go further for another 3/4 a kilometer to 1 kilometer and take a U-turn and come back. So actually, the exact distance from the main road to the project is 3 kilometers. Yeah. You can see. Thank you. You can. It's the same single straight road from Hebbal. And adding that Nanda Gokula Express, the hotel, you'll have to just take a left, which has been shown there. and you reach the project. One beauty about this particular location is it's one of the upcoming areas with the satellite town ring road right opposite. You would have observed it. The four-way lane road is already been done. Actually, it is something which will be expanded into a six-way lane. But the infrastructure right opposite us in terms of the road is already being done. Why I am saying this and highlighting this is any property which is on the main road, you will fetch a very good return. See, there are properties which in and around Devanahalli with other developers who are demanding 6,000, 6,500 rupees, but still people are going and buying because of the type of development which they are doing and the type of infrastructure which they are providing. So this area also has a potential to reach anywhere around 6,000 rupees within a short span of 4 to 5 years. This is something which you can easily pitch. I can give examples. There is, you might be knowing in more details, there are developers like Embassy, Sammy's and all which are already charging 5,500 and above for plots which they are selling in this particular area. And what I would wish to highlight is a property which is on the main road has huge potential to appreciate as compared to properties which are inside smaller roads. So infrastructure plays a massive role in terms of providing a return to any property as such. Yeah, next slide. So Amit, if you could run through the project video. Guys, saw the project, how it would be designed. There is, you might have seen other projects where, or other developments where generally they completely cut down the trees which are there in the project and then build a development as such. But this particular project is another way around. There was no cultivation or anything which was happening from a long period of time. So in this particular land, we are creating a huge green space. If you look at, this is how the master layout plan of the project is being designed. We have divided it into 5 different districts as such. And it is connected through the central spine road, which is a 60 feet road, double road. And you have internal roads varying between 40 feet to 30 feet, depending on the site dimensions which are there. If you could go to the next slide, please. Amit? Yeah, thank you. So there are a lot of USPs in this particular project. The entire project is actually we acquired 100 acres for development, but there were a lot of spaces which we had to leave apart for civic communities and the STRR body. So leaving that apart, we have got 92.5 acres for development in this particular project. The density which is being designed is just 10 plots per acre. So 950 plots is what is being designed. Generally, you might have sold in other areas, in other developments also. The density generally goes anywhere between 20 to 25. Some best might be around 15, 18 plots per acre. But it is much more that. It is actually 10 plots per acre which has been designed in this particular project. You have 6 acres of forest experience which we have created. It's a Japanese technology called Miyawaki technology, through which we are developing almost equivalent to 6 acres of forest experience. There are 14 parks which will be coming up in the project. So a lot of importance has been given to these huge areas of open green lung spaces in the project. We have 2 major clubhouses, which is totaling up to 35,000 square feet. Next slide, please, Amit. So these are the entire set of amenities which we have, which is split across among 2 clubhouses. So you can go through that. We'll be sharing this slide with you. Yeah. Next slide. So I would wish to dwell more on this particular part, because this is something which is unique, which I feel which we are providing in this particular project. The complete set of infrastructure which we are providing is underground. Why I would wish to stress more is, there are a lot of projects across towards North Bangalore which has infrastructure and things coming up and developments happening, where infrastructure, when they say, they provide tar roads and your general electrical poles and things. But here, the entire project complete facilities are underground. When I say underground, right from your sewage, your rainwaters, your electricity, your FTTH, each and everything is completely underground and nothing is visible. Just to give a comparison to your clients, you can just say how you find in developed European nations where everything is completely hidden and you do not see much of electrical poles and things. Something similar sort of a feel is what we are providing in this particular project. Why I would wish to stress on this particular thing is, a person who's expecting a good type of living, this something would really appreciate this particular project as such. So that's where the conversions also have happened in the project. Out of 950 plots, almost 830 plots are already sold. So very few units which are left. So I would request one and all to push and grab this opportunity for your clients. And even, these are the sizes which we, So these are the sizes which are available in the project as such. We have majorly, currently which we have is 3050 size, which we call it as cottage, 3060 variant, which is an 1800 square feet, 4060 is a 2400, and 4080 of 3200 square feet. So these 4 are the major inventory which we have in the project, wherein the price range starts from 58 lakhs
When I say 58 lakhs, I'm talking about it's all inclusive. I can even provide certain schemes onto this particular pricing. So it starts from 58 lakhs. We have certain larger plots. So it ranges between 58 to 1.20 CR. Then we have the little larger, the 1800 variants, which range between 66 lakhs going up to 1.8 because it's almost 5,000 square feet. So we majorly have larger chunk of inventory right now. In terms of sizes, we have good amount of 3,200 square feet variants available in the project, which actually starts from 1.17 going up to 6,752 goes up to 2.47 CR. One thing which I would wish to mention is land is something which is always an appreciating asset, unlike other real estate investments. So the growth which you can expect in land is something which is not something which is fixed. As the area is developing, people can see an abrupt change or a very huge return over a longer period of time on land. Next slide, please. So we have the 1090 scheme as part of the offer. We have actually already applied for the OC for the project, which we will be receiving anywhere very soon, max in a month to two. But still, if somebody wants a little flexible time, we have extended the time. So a person pays 10% now, and the 90% we will be demanding by January 2021, by when the clubhouse will be completed. So I would wish to keep this particular thing clear with you all. Payments are nowhere related to the clubhouse completion, which is also supported by RERA. It states in a plotted development, once the facilities and things are completed, you can always demand and start the registration. If somebody is parallelly willing to register the property or start the construction, they can always do that through our construction link plan. So we provide some sufficient time to pay the remaining 90%. And they can go for the normal construction link plans where we can work out for a good discount on the pricing. So this is about the project. Any question and answers, any questions, we can have a discussion on that.